See, Ganesh Bhagwan is the origin of so many things. So I'll tell you one more funny story today and how he is the origin of a specific tradition also, which we find many places that is happening. So all of you know that story of the fruit. There's a competition between Lord Ganesha and Kartikeya about a fruit, a special fruit. There are various versions of this story in the Puranas itself. In one version of the story, it comes that who should get married first had to be decided. So the competition was whoever goes around the earth first, that person will get married. So Kartikeya set off on his peacock, did the whole pradakshina. But before that, what did Lord Ganesha do? He did parikrama of his parents and he said, the whole world is your form. Now I have done this parikrama. So now this is the fruit you have to give me. So they have to accept because he used his intelligence and they gave him the fruit. And he was married to Riddhi and Siddhi, the daughters of Vishwarupa. So this story we know. But when Kartikeya returned, he was very upset that this is cheating, this should not have happened. And he went away down south. And he said, you got Ganesha married in this way, I will not marry at all. So one of the names of Kartikeya is Kumar, because he was in that phase of, you know, resentment. He didn't like, what is this? I did so much of hard work and this Ganesha just went around the parents and, you know, he got the fruit. So he was in a resentful mood. He went away to the north and he went to a hill called Palani. He's standing on that hill and there are various rishis, yogis, many of them all around him. One day it seems that his Kartikeya was not in a mood to marry at all. And many days passed, months passed. Shivji and Parvatiji used to visit him now and then, spend some time with him. Then they returned to Kailash. So a few months or years passed. One day Kartikeya fell in love with a tribal girl called Valli. And this Valli, she is a tribal girl and they used to have millet fields and, you know, they used to work in the millet fields. So she is a laborer. She works in the millet fields. So Kartikeya fell in love with her. But he tried many methods. She just does not accept his proposal and she turns him down, you know. And this Kartikeya was very dejected and disappointed. So he said, you know, my brother is a remover of all obstacles. Finally, I will have to pray to him only that, you know, do something and get us both married. So he called Ganesha. Ganesha came immediately because the resentment was there. See, sibling rivalry is there. Na? So he went away. But this Ganesh ji, when his brother called, he came very promptly. He came because he's also missing. He's only one sibling he has that went away. So Ganesh ji came. He said, what happened? He said, you know, that girl, I love her very much, but she is not accepting. So that's all. Okay. Just see what I will do. And that Lord Ganesha, he took the form of a huge elephant and he charged in the millet fields where Valli was working. His Valli got terrified. Oh God, this elephant is running and coming, and she thought that elephant is just around to eat something. But after some time, she saw that elephant is targeting her and he is coming towards her. She got very frightened and scared and she looked around, what should I do? And she started running, and the elephant is coming closer and closer. And finally, what happens? Kartikeya is standing there and she goes and hits Kartikeya. And Kartikeya with his spear and, you know, with his, you know, courage and all that, he manages to shoo away this elephant, and the elephant also goes away. And Valli feels secure and safe in the embrace of Kartikeya. And Valli says, thank you for saving me and protecting me. and she consents. And that is how Kartikeya and Valli got married. So many of these Bollywood legends, you see, na, what they do, they have some chore or they have some thief or somebody who will be there and, you know, the hero will bash them up and the heroine falls for it. The tradition is set by Lord Ganesha. I'm just joking, okay? Don't take it seriously and don't feel offended and all that. What I mean to say is that, you know, Ganesh ji, he took care of his brother also, and all the resentment of his brother and everything was removed because of Ganesh ji's grace. Yesterday we saw, no, that without invoking Ganesh ji, when Vedavyasji started writing something, he could not remember. Shivji could not kill Tarakasura without remembering Ganesh ji. Many such instances are there. So we should always invoke Lord Ganesha whenever we are in trouble, and in all ways he will help. Not just by giving knowledge or not by giving only prosperity, in all other ways also Bhagwan helps.